Christian McCaffrey has signed a 2-year extension for $19 million per year, says sources to Adam Schefter. McCaffrey will receive an extra additional $8 million over what he was scheduled to make for the first 2 years while adding $24 million in guarantees. The deal was negotiated and confirmed by WME Football, who has been on a couple different tweets over the last couple days getting deals done. I believe Justin Jefferson, also WME. Congrats to Christian McCaffrey. We didn't think about him. But Ayuk, you know, because they got the Juwan Jennings deal done. We thought Ayuk was potentially going to be next there. Instead, it was Christian McCaffrey needs to get a little bit more money so that we can pay him a fair market share for what he does for our team. Now, obviously, you would think, like John Lynch, Kyle Shanahan feel an obligation to take care of their guy who has been their bell cow since getting dropped in there. But now this raises so many more questions. First of all, congratulations to Christian. We're happy for him, AJ. He's a dynamic player.
He's awesome.
Love
him. He is, but what do we do now, though? I mean, credit to them for getting out in front of it, I think, because we know how awesome Christian actually is, but they have a long list, man. This is why I do not envy GMs and what they have to do and how you have to find, kind of manipulate the roster and the salary cap.
$8 million more per year, too. Just how's that happen? Does Christian McCaffrey's people come up and say, hey, just real quick, we need more money?
Yeah.
And Lynch is like, everybody needs more money. Like, I need more. You should see what they're paying me. Yeah, I'm not happy about it. Or is this John Lynch potentially looking at the market and going, hey, we view you as running back and wide receiver and weapon with what other people are this is probably what you're due. And Brock Purdy is still on a rookie deal, so we're able to do this now as opposed to what's about to happen in the future. I do wonder how this plays.
I know. It is interesting. I don't think anyone gotten close to Christian McCaffrey? I know Barkley just got a new deal, but I don't think he was anywhere near to that. Like, to your point, he is, you know, he can be used anywhere. He can be a running back. He can be a wide receiver. And he means so much to that team. As dynamic as they are and as great as Brock Purdy is, it starts with that run game, C-Mac, and then once he splits out, he's always a matchup nightmare.
So Christian was at 16 a year, which was the highest paid running back. Second was Kamara at 15, Jonathan Taylor at 14. So now he goes to 19, which, you know, puts a decent little gap in there.
Yeah, and will somebody else try to utilize that as negotiation, or will we see the same standstill on the running back market, except for if you're Christian McCaffrey, who is their weapon, that he is their, now granted, got a lot of explosives outside and a tight end position, and Brock Purdy's been able to hit them all perfectly, but all of it goes because there is a real fear of what the hell Christian McCaffrey is about to do, and I guess that's what they're doing. They're putting money where their mouth is.
Well, with him, right? This is kind of all she wrote for Brandon Ayuk. There's kind of no way that they're bringing him back, and also goes to the point that they drafted a first-round wide receiver.
Brock Purdy's deal affords you a lot of movement. It gives you a lot of opportunity because he was last pick of the, so not only rookie contract, worst rookie contract is at the highest paid position at quarterback, that's normally eating 20% of salary cap. So you have a lot of room to wiggle with whenever you have Brock Purdy at your quarterback, but they're going to have to do a lot of wiggling. I mean that is certainly a wiggle party about to take place in San Fran if they want to keep the same cast of characters around maybe for another Super Bowl run after this year.
Well, and if you just look at a guy like Ayuk in his situation, if there is any kind of negotiation, like after something like this happens, like you think he's happy. He's just like, if he's not getting exactly what he wants, like, why wouldn't he just be like, no, like, you're paying all these other guys. We're talking about, you know, what you're going to give Purdy next year, who after all these guys get paid, he's probably going to be making over $50 million a year. It's just like, it seems like they've kind of already made their bed and they're okay with losing Ayuk.
Hey, Ayuk, come to Indianapolis.